Your goodwill, the next step is goodwill. Given total value 18,000 given. So in this business, Rahu is retired. Then here you want know this, Rahu share is 1/6. So 18,000 into 1/6. 1/6 means 3:2, 2:1, 3+2, 5+1, 6, 3/6. So 6 1 ja, 6 3 ja. 3,000. So these 3,000 continuing partners will take this, their 1:1 ratio. So 1:1 ratio means 1500 and 1500. So both are 3,000. Then entry is for here continuing partners account data to retiring partner. Your continuing partners is Chandra. Chandra capital account data. Chandra capital account data. Next, Bhaskar capital account data. Bhaskar capital account data. Next, to Rahu capital account. Then it is 1500, then 3000. So we should record this entry in capital accounts. So in this entry, Chandra capital and Bhaskar capital is debited. Then we should write this debit side to Rahu capital account. Rahu capital account, that is 1500 and 1500. And again it is in Rahu capital credit side by Chandra capital account and by Rahu cap, sorry, by Bhaskar capital account. That is 1500 and 1500. Next, your properties. The next one, properties 6,000 total. Should write both sides is 6,000. Now the debit amount is 17 + 7, 24,000. So it is in working notes. Credit amount is 6,000. And debit amount is 2400. So 3600 is the profit. So 3600. So here you should write here to Chandra capital account to Bhaskar to Rahu capital account. This 3600 is distributed. 3600 is distributed into the ratio 3:2:1. That means 3/6. 6 1 ja 6 6 ja 36. So 1800 is first one. Okay, next. Next one is 3600 into next ratio is 2.6. second partner is Bhaskar is 2 3 3 1 3 12. So 1200. And last partner is, that means Rahu partner, retiring partner, is 3600 into 1/6. So it is 600. So their total, this revaluation profit is 1800 is Chandra and 1200 is Bhaskar and Rahul is 600. So again it is 1800 and it is 1200 and it is 600. So total 3600. Again we should transfer to this capital account, their capital account, by revaluation account. Revaluation account. that is Chandra Capital, 1800. Next, Bhaskar Capital, 1200. Next, Rahu Capital, 3600. So, revaluation account is completed. Next one, ascertain the balances of capital accounts. So, now the capital accounts. In these capital accounts, first one is then Chandra Capital, that is 30,000 plus 800, 31,800. And second one is 20 plus 1200, 21,200. Next, 21, 22, 23. So, 26,600. Next same 31,800, 21,200 and 26,600. Okay, next this is next balance carry down 31,800 minus 1,500. That is balances is here 31,800 Chandra, that minus 1,500. $30,300 is Chandra Capital. Next again, Bhaskar 21,200 minus 1,500. Next 700 is next one is 26,600. Here 26,600. So 6, then 100 is 23,600. Is again 23,600. Again it is transferred to 23,600 is Rahu. Loan account, that is here again by balance brought down, that is Chandra 30,300 and Bhaskar 19,700. Then again it is transferred to Rahul loan account. Then in capital account we have written debit side, then in Rahu loan account we should write credit side. It is transferred from this Rahu capital account, so it should write here by Rahu capital account, that is 23,600. So here no balance, then ascertain balances to balance carry down, that is 23,600. Again, it is by balance brought down, that is 23,600. Here again, Rahu loan account is liability, so his amount is totally transferred to Rahu capital, amount is transferred to Rahu loan account, that is 23,600. And again their capital is also liability capital accounts. Here is Chandra and next Bhaskar. Chandra is 30,300 and Bhaskar is 19,700. Now the totals. Here, liability amount is 10, liability is here 20 and 23,600, 30,300 and 19,700. 0 and 0, 7 plus 3, 10 plus 6, 16, 10, 13, 2, 5, 7, 9, 10. So 1,03,600, 1,03,600. Next, again here also, 10,800, 12,000, 28,300. And 10,500 and 42,000. So again it is 1,03,600. So here our balance sheet is tallied. Then here this balance sheet is actually continuing partners Chandra, Bhaskar, okay, balance sheet of Chandra and Bhaskar. So this is the problem number 13.